Richards, and I'm your lector this evening. Today's Mass is being offered for Frank and Tawana Sr. Today we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. Our celebrant for this Mass is Father Matt. This evening's announcements. There is a second collection this weekend for Catholic school subsidiary. Ascension Thursday, a holy day of obligation, is this Thursday, May 30th. Check the bulletin for Mass times. There is a vigil on Wednesday, May 29th at 6 p.m. here at St. Emma's. Attention to all who have keys to the church, religion, or school. Wednesday, May 29th, we will be changing the locks to these buildings. If you have a key to one of these facilities, please contact the rectory office. St. Vitus School presents the 14th Annual Night at the Races fundraiser on Friday, May 17th at Mary Mother of Hope Parish. Beginning this weekend, tickets are on sale after all masses for our new parish festival raffle tickets beginning this weekend. The cost of the ticket is $50 with 12 chances to win. Total prize money is $24,000 with a grand prize of $15,000. Checks should be made payable to St. Vitus. Please see a member of the festival committee after Mass to purchase your ticket. We ask at this time that you silence your electronic devices. Please be sure to take home a bulletin to keep up with the many events happening in our parish. Let us now stand to greet Christ in one another and join in our opening hymn.
Through my thoughts, through my words, 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 through my th Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Some who had come down from Judea were instructing the brothers, "Unless you are circumcised according to the Mosaic practice, you cannot be saved." Because there arose no little dissension and debate by Paul and Barnabas with them, it was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and elders about this question. The apostles and elders, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and to send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. The ones chosen were Judas, who was called Barsabbas, and Silas, leaders among the brothers. This is the letter delivered by them. The apostles and the elders, your brothers, to the brothers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia, of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number who went out without any mandate from us have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have, with one accord, decided to choose representatives and to send them to you along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey the same message by word of mouth. It is the decision of the Holy Spirit and of us not to place on you any burden beyond these necessities, namely to abstain from meat sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meats of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. It gleamed with the splendor of God. Its radiance was like that of a precious stone, like jasper, clear as crystal. It had a massive high wall, with 12 gates where 12 angels were stationed, and on which names were inscribed, the names of the 12 tribes of the Israelites. There were 3 gates facing east, 3 north, 3 south, and 3 west. The walls of the city had 12 courses of stones as its foundation, on which were inscribed the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb. The city had no need of the sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gave it light, and its lamp was the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Maybe a business,
church. They had three boys. When he turned 57 years old, he unexpectedly died, leaving behind his wife, who was 50. She had an 11-year-old, a 26-year-old, and a 29-year-old. But the 29-year-old was struggling. The 26-year-old just began a new life and had very little resources. And of course, the 11-year-old was being an 11-year-old. Shortly after the death of her husband, she ran out of money. Her two older boys didn't realize this until it was too late. This woman, who was a loving, loving mother, had to file bankruptcy in order to save her only home, an old company house in an old mining town. She was blessed to live to be 73 years old. And when she died, her boys had to help pay for the burial. But what she left behind was something beyond anything money could buy. She left behind a mother's love. She instilled in her three boys the gift of faith and trust in God no matter what happens. She was always cheerful, joyful in all the trials of life she faced. And she left behind a legacy of love, but not one man. And I know, because that is my feeling. She, my mom, and Dad. What do you want to leave behind? Jesus is talking to his disciples before he dies. He leaves behind no material thing. The soldiers even fight over his clothes. But what he leaves behind is the promise of his Holy Spirit. Everything in this life is always changing. From the moment we're conceived, our cells are dividing. We are growing to become the adult person God intended us to be. And then after that, we start to grow until the destiny of dust. My mom used to say, the golden years are a bit rusty. We're always in a state of change. The world is always spinning. Nature around us is always changing. And yet there's something in the human heart that longs for consistency. We want something that's stable. We want to hold on to something that lasts. Yet everything around us is slipping through our fingers. What Jesus leaves behind to his followers is that what is eternal. His Spirit. That's his gift. To lead and guide us into eternity. Beyond this world. I don't think it's an accident
that our new parish is called Holy Spirit. Because that's his gift to us, the Spirit.
Now, you might not believe this, but when I was assigned here, I thought we need to come up with an image, a logo. And I worked with some people that I knew who would help us with their skills and talents. And they came up with that image. It's on our parish prayer of the Holy Spirit. So that we would be one in the Spirit. And he put the seven stars there for the seven different parishes. And it just kind of came together. Not in my wildest dream did I think that our one parish would be named Holy Spirit. And then that logo will change so that those stars become flames that are alive and active to symbolize not just the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, but the seven gifts that each of these parishes are as we come to one. Why did the Lord leave the Spirit? Why didn't he just stay here? He was risen from the dead. The disciples ate with him. He showed them his wounds. Because Jesus doesn't want to live outside of us. He wants to live inside us. That's why he insists on leaving and yet staying. Staying in the person and power of his Spirit that dwells in us. So that we can grapple with the hard questions. Because he didn't answer them all before he left. He couldn't. We wouldn't be ready. How could he talk to his disciples about consolidating parishes? They'd think he was on something. Maybe marijuana. It's legal now. How can he talk with us? Stem cell research. How can we talk to them about what should we do? Medical ethics. No, he said, I promise you the Spirit. And so what happens? The minute he leaves, there is confusion. Do we become Jews before we become Christian? Do we have to have circumcision? Is that the covenant in the blood? The disciples don't know. So what do they have to do? They have to come together, they have to pray, they have to trust in God, and they have to rely on his Holy Spirit that he promised. And if you notice in that reading, they say they are guided by the Spirit. You don't have to enter into the Mosaic covenant to be a Christian. And they opened up the faith to the Gentiles. So what do we have to do in our day and age? In the challenges that we face, in the decisions we have to make, no matter what they are, you and your personal life and your family, your own self, we as a community, a diocese, the church around the world, we have to turn to his gift of the Spirit. Ask the Lord to lead and guide us. And detach from the material and attach to the spiritual. Because that, my friends, is the only thing that is everlasting. And if my mother taught me anything, it was that. What are you going to leave behind? What's the most important thing to possess? What lasts forever? I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth. All things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father.
Church, may the Holy Spirit grant us the gifts of wisdom and knowledge, and joyfully proclaiming the gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For agricultural ministers and those who tend the land, and for all who work to cultivate and distribute food to those most in need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are burdened by mental illness, may they experience God's love through those who assist them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of us gathered here, may God open our hearts in the workings of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Frank Montuano Sr., may they find rest in the arms of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now let us recite our parish prayer found in the front of the hymnal. Lord Jesus, you told us where your treasure is.
There you are us also. The parish is the Lawrence County. Treasure our faith in you, our children, and every person who gathers here. Help us to have the courage to sacrifice, love, and to build in your name. Guide us by your spirit of wisdom. Give success to the work of our hands, and keep us in your peace.
Let us all pray together in Psalm number 215 in the Missalette, Mine Eyes Have Seen the Glory, number 215.
Thank you.
so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, but especially during this sacred time when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and even pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain, who lives forever. And so, with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts with your praise. Even heavenly powers and angelic hosts sing together in name of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took a chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." After the example of Christ and his command, may your church stand as a living witness to truth and justice, peace and freedom, that all people may be raised up in new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who all fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to the joy and the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us that when our earthly pilgrimages die, we may enter into an eternal dwelling place in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, St. Joseph, your apostles and martyrs, where we too will praise and exalt in the presence of Christ, our risen Lord. Through him, with him, and him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
controller so he can tell me what to do when I fly.
Richard, congratulations.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.